Going into some close quarters. Oh my god! Oh, I got the shotgun out. It was probably a good decision, given what I just climbed down that ladder into. Uh-oh, this is gonna be bad. G'day, guys. My name's Josh. Yo, can call me Ja Woodle, and welcome back once again to 7 Days to Die Alpha 17 for a very important episode of the No Crafting Challenge. And it's very important because this will be the last episode of the No Crafting Challenge. Come hell or high water, this will be the very last one. And it's because I just survived the Day 28 Blood Moon Horde without really breaking a sweat. In fact, the closest I came to dying was myself. I fired a rocket and was blew myself into several different pieces, but the zombies have actually got close to killing me themselves. They kind of like shone a light on the fact that I've become just a walking apocalyptic god in this playthrough. All of my gear is all level 6, everything is like primo awesome, so I don't think there's much of a challenge left in this, except for one of those big factory places, the big factory POIs, which I found a couple over the journey, the tier 5 dungeons. So I figured, hey, why not to finish this series off, because clearly there's nothing else I can do right now. To finish this off properly, let's go raid one of those things. So that seems like a pretty good idea to me. There was a couple of different ideas on how I should end it. For example, someone suggested I should try and get $100,000 redos, but I already have $100,000 redos. So I am rolling into Benjamins. I am loving life in the No Crafting Challenge. Well, it's time to wrap it up, and to wrap it up properly, the only way to do it is to potentially kill myself. I'm not gonna lie, I'm actually reasonably nervous about this. I've never actually taken down— oh, there's Eldo Cabin. Goodbye, Eldo Cabin. Thank you for all you did for me. Thank you for somehow making some sort of corridor on top of the roof there and letting the zombies kind of slide their way down into the gutter. But yeah, I'm actually pretty nervous about this this tier 5 dungeon, because I've never— oops, shit, that was some terrible driving. I've never actually defeated one properly. I mean, sure, I've built my way up to the roof before, I've framed up and got the loot and stuff, but I don't think I've ever actually gone through the proper way and taken the designed path from start to finish on one of those things. So it's going to be an interesting day. If I'm ever in a good spot to do it, it's going to be this opportunity, because, but I didn't show this before I left, inside the 4x4 truck here is every bullet that I've ever found. All the arrows, all the repair kits, all the rockets, all the pipe bombs, all the first aid shit. I have everything inside. Oh, actually, I just took everything out. I have everything I'm ever going to possibly need inside my 4x4. So when I get there, I'm going to be armed to the teeth. I have my sledgehammer as well, but there shouldn't be anything in there that can't go a bullet to the face, so I should hopefully be able to get through it. If not, I'll die, and that'll be the end of it that way. So I'll either succeed and be crowned the champion of no crafting, or I'll get my teeth knocked out by some yeti fuck once again, and I'll have to concede defeat. But either way, this is going to be the last one. There it is. Look how big it is. That is going to be a task and a half to get through all of that, but I'm excited for the challenge. Lots of good loot up the top. Not that I really need it at this point. I've got loot for days as it stands right now. Just park my Jeep up out the front, as any good prospective client would. Shotgun Messiah. Oh my god. Raiding a gun factory. There's going to be so many zombies in here, I'm not going to know what to do with myself. And before I go in, you'll see I do have all my weapons down on the hotbar, including, for a change, the Magnum, which with all these mods on it looks pretty bloody ridiculous. It's big, it's beefy, and it shoots, oh, if I can hit some targets, like an absolute cock in the face. God, stop, stop. Ah, damn it, I can't do it. I can't scope in. Can I kill that fucking Zop Vulture, please? Not a good start if I couldn't shoot a bloody vulture out of the sky when he wasn't even zigzagging that much. But I do have a purple Magnum, because why not? I had to put the purple dye on this from my compound bow, so that's now green. But I figured, I've never actually used this before, I should probably roll with it now, just to give it a crack. Oh, alright, this is the final challenge, the Shotgun Messiah Factory. Let's get this going, let's get it rolling. Silence pistols out for the boys. Oh my god, I'm not gonna leave that door ever again. This is it. Just because I'm going into this expecting to die doesn't mean I'm not gonna play it seriously and try and keep my stealth up and try not to get into too many fights that I don't need to. I mean, look, if it all really kicks off and everyone comes for me, it's not gonna be too bad to have all the firepower this side of Alabama to try and knock them all down with. Oh, hey there, buddy. Ah, that's why you get the silence pissed. Ah, ha, ha. Ow, damn it. Okay, stand up. Is that a feral? No, it's just a slowpoke. Well, how did they catch up to me so quick? Where did they come from? Where did they go, you hard hat wearing Joe? Okay, now they're all working up. You know what? Fine. Let's test out the Magnum then. I'm gonna have it. I may as well use it. Oh, that feels good. It's loud, it's brutal, and it wrecks fucking zombie faces. See, now normally I would just scrap the steel ammo there, but in this case, I've got lots of zombies to kill and lots of ammo to do it with. Plus, I've already got the Magnum out, so I may as well just reload and use that steel ammo for like the first time ever. Wait for the shot. Get one into you. One into you, and one into you too. All the magnum is good. Still doesn't feel quite as like heavy and as visceral as I would kind of like it to be. I think it's just the sound clip, like the actual sound effect you get when you shoot it. I feel like it needs a bit more bass. Having like I've got a heavier sound effect would make it feel a lot heavier in the hand, make it feel like you're really blasting some Jeffries apart. But yeah, whatever. I'm trying to pick on something, trying to find a reason not to use it, because I'd always rather use my silenced pistol over the magnum every day of the week. I can hear lots more Jeffries being awake and alive somewhere. I just have to find where they are. There's now an opening to the outside world, which is no fun. I'm probably going to loot that little working assist box as well. In fact, you know what? I'm going to take my rocket launcher out of my hotbar. I can just see it now. I normally have like bandages or my frames or my sledgehammer or something in my last slot. I'm just going to expect to be finding my sledgehammer there, roll onto my rocket launcher and blow myself apart. Because as we know, the biggest threat to my health is myself. Got one more bullet left with the steel ammo. Anyone in here want to cop it in the gob? Anyone around? Oh, yep, there's a boy. There's a boy. Come on, up the ramp. No, run in the straight line. Ah, you bastard. You weaved. You swerved and I missed the shot. All right, bandage up. You know what? Fine. If you're going to cause me so many issues, I'll just bust out Old Faithful and put a shotgun down your throat. I've got 4 points to spend that I haven't spent yet. So let's go one into there and a couple into Gunslinger, I guess. I'm going to put one in there, I suppose. All right, so yeah, might as well level up the points that relate to the guns that I'm now using. God, they're coming through that wall. That's okay. Anyone else around here? Anyone else? There should be plenty of people inside this little area here. I mean, my entire experience with these factories is that you get like 3 rooms in and then there's just nothing but a wall of zombies. So I'm kind of expecting that to happen again here. But no one's really doing anything. There's so many zombies beating on shit. The game's struggling again, despite having one of the most powerful PCs you can get right now. It's still ST-ruggling with all the zombies. But it's okay. They'll fix that in Alpha 18. Right, they're up there. They're not doing anything. Let's continue on. There's a secret over there, it looks like, because the pool is half empty. Anyone? Oh, hey, buddy, how you doing? Anyone else around? Nope, just you. I mean, that's okay. I'll kill you, but I need your friends to know that you've been murdered so they can come and try and avenge you. Or I can just line them up like hens in a chook house and pick off one by one. Boom, just like that. Oh, I cannot wait until the penetration perk in Alpha 18. It's gonna be such a good time. The Magnum is definitely making life just that little bit easier, especially with that like 2x scope. Normally not a big fan of scopes. Oh, that was a shit shot. But in this case, I'm actually kind of enjoying it. Can I hit this muffin, please? Wait for a decent shot then. If you're gonna make my life difficult, there you go. Come on, over this way. That one missed as well. There we go, finally got him. Not a great exhibition of your shooting skills there, Joshy boy. You should really get your shit sorted out. All right, so now that all this is now empty, though, let's go back and check that pool for super secret stashes. I guess that's the way I go after that. Okay, I'll be right back. I don't want to leave any stone unturned because I rarely get the opportunity to come and raid these kinds of factories. Ah, there is a secret on here. It's not where the water was, or wasn't, rather. The water over here is just kind of broken for some reason, but that's okay. Right, what's in here? Anything good? Shotguns out to make sure nothing gets surprises me. Some, like, aquatic zombies wouldn't go amiss. You know, like some sharks or, like, piranhas or something. Zombified piranhas actually sounds like a horrifying mess. I'm kind of glad they aren't in this. Hidden stash with a military helmet and some silver nugs, but I'm so full of just ammo and all the things I'm going to need for this raid that I'm not going to take any of the loot. I don't need loot at this point. Got 100 Gs at home. I don't need to take anything to sell. I'll be fine without it. I'm going to go back up here, grab my sledge out, and there you go, good boy. Nice heavy hit. Swing your sledgey like you mean it. Oh my god. I heard the swinging arms and it was a rad right next to me. Well, it's going to be a rad. I'm going to need the shotgun. I need to stop you from regenerating. Oh, didn't put you down. I have to put your friend down first. There we go. Quickly reroad light in your face. Ah, there we go. Ah, damn it. God, you take so long to die. So long to die. She's one stiff son of a bitch. But that's right, we got it down eventually. Even though the shotgun took longer than it normally should, I'll put that down to my shooting rather than the shotgun letting me down, because I refuse to speak ill of the oh shit shotgun. In fact, I should go back to crouching now, given that I'm back up into an area where zombies haven't woken up yet. Die. Didn't wake up any friends. I hope you didn't. Yep, you woke up a couple. Alright, well, if you're gonna wake everyone up, I may as well just go loud then. This guy's trapped underneath the walkway. Oh, no, he's not. Okay, well, that's alright, buddy. I'll let you out. I'll take out both your knees, though. One in each kneecap. You won't be running after me for a long time. Well, it's still, I mean, even though I was just talking before, as I talk a shit about the sound effect for the Magnum, it's still super satisfying to blow Jeffries away right in the face. It feels good to do, and when the heads explode, it's just that extra little cherry on top of awesome, just to give that little, like, visceral reward for doing something cool. Take the bullets, anything else in here? I mean, it's a bloody, whatchamacallit, what am I trying to say? A gun... Oh my god, a shotgun messiah factory. So there should be ammo left, right, and center in this place. I mean, I was expecting more out of that though. These are all working stiff boxes, don't care about that. All right, shotgun back out, let's keep going. And take the hay bales from the other side because I want something to build my way over with without wasting my precious frames. Go like one here and just build a little stack like that. All right, up over the top. Is there anyone down here? Is there any secrets down here? Someone's left their purse behind. Probably should be back here anyway, Dale. This is a dangerous place to be, especially leaving your purse behind. Anything hiding behind all the hay? No, there's not. So it's just like an actual firing range with nothing going on. All right, fine. That's a little bit anticlimactic. I was expecting so much more. Throw all that shit away. Get the shotgun back out and keep on going. There's so many zombies awake and like beating through walls that I'm not sure where I'm supposed to be going. Oh, except now I see you. There's a bunch of brats coming. Line up. Pop one in the face, one after the other. Ah, it just feels good. Feels good. Oh boy, I woke up in a couple of bathrooms worth of Jeffreys. That's quite a few Muppets all in the bathroom together. I don't really want to know what you were doing in there, but thank you for coming out and opening the red carpet, giving me the welcome party that I feel like I deserve. That's a fair bit of slaughter right there. The Magnum does not care how many zombies are taking a dump at once. It only cares how many zombies it can shoot at once, which is still only one, I suppose. But it feels good to line them all up and get headshot after headshot. No one else in here. Going upstairs. It could be some... Oh, there could be some vultures up here, aren't there? I hate vultures. Get the pistol out for vultures. Because having 22 rounds to shoot them up with is going to be better than just the 6. Is there someone down... Oh, yeah. I see him. There are a couple of more Muppets down here. Cause me issues. And I would very much like some peace and quiet if you could stop beating on my shit. Oh, boy. See what I mean? How are you right next to me? How did I not see you? Oh, there's a cop there as well. All right, we're going to have to break out something a little bit more heavy-handed. There's some vultures flying in. Knock. I told you there'd be vultures up here. As soon as I saw we're going up that side, I knew I was going to have to fight a bunch of vultures, and I was not excited about it. Those stupid decaying chickens caused me nothing but issues. They gave me salmonella just from looking at me, and I'd rather just stay well clear of them. Okay, and no one else around. That's the good thing about having all these different weapons. Like, I have an arsenal on me right now. I'm cruising around with more weapons than the Doom Marine. So whatever kind of situation I get into, I can usually pick what's going to be best for me and take out whatever opponents I may have without too much worries. Are they on the other side of a glass window? Yes, they are, but now they're not. Oh, yep. Oh, dude, come on. You took a board in the face. You're supposed to die. That's just rude. Oh, look at them all. Look at them all. I've woken up so many Jeffreys inside there. They're all humming around like a freaking beehive waiting for the opportunity to come and sting my nostrils. Just come on, keep on going through, around the light. I got the shotgun out, because it's going to be a bad time when I do actually find where all these guys are, which seems to be right here. But that's okay. I'm happy to sit here and blow them all away, because they all have to come to me at this point. They can't get any other way. Did someone just fall down? Oh, he's dead. Okay, that's good. I was going to say, they fall down there and they're still alive. They're going to go break something I don't want on the break, and we're going to have a bad time. They're going to shit in my spaghetti sauce, and no one's going to be happy about that. There we go. Nice, easy headshot. There'll be a whole bunch more Jeffreys in here. That's right. It's the Magnum's time to shine once again. Ah, it feels good. So satisfying making him do backflips. Oh, hey, buddy. How you doing? I hope you're having a good time. I am with my Magnum. Oh, boy. I don't even have the anti-radar on the Magnum. Like, what do I have? I don't think I showed that off. Got the barrel light, purple dye, crippleum, scope, and muzzle brake, which is just kind of all the mods I had left over that I could fit onto it. Anyone else in here? That's why, I mean, look, I normally roll with the shotgun for exactly that situation. A big, green, radiated bastard coming in to try and rearrange my face, make me into a Picasso. But, I mean, the Magnum does just the same. Anything that will, like, stumble them down, make me kind of second guess having to mess me up. There we go. Yeah, the shotgun's always going to be the best. I should just be rolling with the shotgun and nothing else, because it's always served me well. I found some fort bites, and I haven't really used them before, so I'll use those ones to throw them away. I feel invincible. I mean, I kind of already did, given the fact that I'm a walking military complex. Anyone else right here? Nothing in there. There we go. Wake everyone up. May as well. Got the fort bites going for me anyway. I'm thirsty as balls. That's okay. Not only am I thirsty for water, I'm also zombie bloodthirsty. So everyone, please, come party at the bloody... smelting control room, whatever this is. I'd very much like to have a dance with you. Oh, wow. Oh, that's a lot of them. That is a lot of them, but I've got something special for them. Bust out the old rocket launcher. I didn't have it on me, but that's okay. Reload. Everyone, yeah, look at them. Just got cruising through the doorway. Oh! Ah, now they're all cruising into hell. I mean, you'll fit in there. You're already charred and disfigured and burning. I feel like that's what most people in hell will look like. So you just go in there, you'll automatically be one of those popular people in the entire of the caverns. Raiding the medical supply place to try and get more bandages or health or whatever, I don't really mind. I don't need an extra thing of painkillers. I'll throw that one away. I've got 50 of them already. If I need them, I've got them. Anything in here? I also wouldn't mind some extra fluids, given I only brought two. I didn't bring much food or drink, which is a little bit silly. Oh, we're going into a new room. Just get the crouch on. Oh, too late. Already woke everyone up. Are you a feral? No, it's the normal. That's okay. One, it's you, and then one in the dick. All right, one of the other dick. Apparently got two down there. One shot and one dick would usually be enough to wear someone out, or at least like stop them from getting up again. That guy had an extra sausage that needed to be thrown on the barbie. Anyone else around here? I can't. Oh, I see you over there. No, easy, easy. There we go, right on the top of the head. Here was a feral, so we took two. This is good though. This is good. We're making good progress. It's Jesus. It's already almost. It's 2:30. Which means that I don't have a lot longer left before nighttime. And trying to take on this joint in the middle of the night seems like a recipe for me to end it by dying. I can hear a buddy pelican out here somewhere, but oh, there he is. He's gone behind the sun. He's read the dogfighting 101 manual, and he's attacking me from directly in the sunlight, so I couldn't see him. Clever birdie. Not clever enough to avoid the bullets, but clever to make it a little bit more difficult for me than it would be otherwise. Kill you. No one else around here. There was a bunch here before, but I murdered them all as I was trying to beat their way through the spikes over there. We're doing okay so far. Every time I go outside, though, I pucker just a little bit more. I clench just that little bit more because I never like going out there because there's always going to be, oh my god, some douchebag out there ready to peck my brains out. I swung the sledgehammer so slowly then. I'm surprised I didn't do like half damage given how slowly I swung this bloody thing. Stop it. Oh my god. Okay, they're all coming down. That's enough. And if you don't cause this many issues, then you'll get the shotgun. I was trying to be nice and stealthy. But if you're going to do that, then you can all just die in front of me. This doesn't really seem like how it was supposed to go. I can't quite get up. I keep banging my head on the bloody roof above, but I can almost get there. Almost there we go. Okay. Made it up. Not the easiest path to follow, but it's all right. We got there in the end. I am hot. I am thirsty. I've got withdrawals from Fort Bots because I ate one time. Kill you. Sneak across the elevator. There's going to be lots of Jeffreys up here. I don't know what the withdrawals actually do to me in regards to like what effects it takes away from. Maybe it like decreases my perception or something like that, so I'm not actually doing as much damage as I was a second ago. Buddy, buddy, please. Have you not seen me murder every single person who looks like you before? I've been going on a freaking rampage. You think creeping up behind me by yourself is going to be a good tactic? Not clever, mate. Not clever at all. Learn from the bloody pelicans outside and try and use some tactics. Oh, wow. Oh, a lot of them just came around the corner, but that's okay. There's a group of three, so I'll quickly murder all those guys. But it almost murdered all of them. It's pretty good. One of them survived because he was away from the blast radius, but he couldn't avoid the shotgun. Is there more coming? That looks a big group for me. Boom, another one. Mainly used the rocket launcher while I got it. It almost killed me in the horde night, but as long as I'm not stupid and firing into my feet again, I should be pretty okay. Plus, it's a super satisfying exploding zombies. Oh, we're going outside again. I don't want to go outside again. I liked it inside and away from the pecky claws of the pelicans. Where are they going to be? They're out here somewhere. Keep your wits about you. Make sure they don't sneak up on you. When they sneak up on you is the worst time, because then you just hear the screechy squawk of a pelican going behind you. Then you feel the talons ripping through your spinal cord. Like you. I see you. Running to you. Is that... Oh god, he went absolutely flying. That's still one of the most satisfying things. When you shoot a vulture with a pistol, they get absolutely launched like a little green man in Kerbal Space Program. They could almost go into orbit like that. In fact, I'd very much like to see it happen. What even is going... Oh, these are military guys? Like, oh no, they're bloody working, but I can't see their bloody heads. All right, let's do this another way. Let's go around here and go like that to try and get on top of the railing with my stealth on. Damn it, I woke them up. I was trying not to. I guess you can't have everything in life. Well, if the bullets didn't kill them, the drop surely should have. Nope, it didn't. God, yeah, those hard hats are worth more than we think they are. Oh, I heard the flaps. I hear the flap somewhere. I don't know where the pelican is, but I have to find him first because he's going to sneak up on me otherwise. It's going to be a real bad time. Where are you, flappy bastard? I know you're out here somewhere. I can hear the flaps. Right, maybe I just need to just like run inside and close the door behind me. You can't get through a steel door. Well, at least I hope you can. I don't know. They have pretty strong beaks and pretty strong talons. Maybe they can do whatever they damn well please, regardless of how I feel about the situation. Anyone else in here? Oh, that's like the lobby. We've gone a whole full circle. We're back to almost where we started. I feel like I don't trust any of these bloody plates. I'm going to walk on the railings, which traditionally don't break away from underneath you. There's a big gap at the end. Well, who broke the bloody floorboards? That's just rude. Oh, oh my god. Oh, I saw him just as I made the jump across. I was already nervous about the jump, and just as I jumped, I saw him cruise across the doorway. He could have blocked me out there and sent me back to the start. That would have been pretty bloody frustrating. Oh, there he is. He was trapped inside. I knew I could hear a vulture, but he was stuck inside this little room. Huh, that's actually kind of funny. So I've been upgrading as well my Gunslinger perk. So now, if I can put another one almost into it. So look, 4 successive hits in a short time causes the last body to 100 extra damage, plus 5 successive hits in a short time causes critical damage. So if you start railing some Jeffreys with the pistol, which I'm about to, but given the sounds that there's an entire horde waiting for me outside, then you're going to do a fair amount of damage. I'm pretty excited to test the theory out, but I need to find everyone first. I keep going back into the same rooms, and I've already woken everyone up because I was rolling through loud as a thunderstorm before. I just need to find another group of zombies and start blowing them away. Here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4. There we go. That should have given me the extra points. Right, so can I just like murder all of you guys now? Well, I've got a green pistol next to my name, even though I'm bleeding out of my asshole right now. Let's quickly just sort. Oh my god, I need to fix that. I can't have the bandages next to the bloody rocket launcher. I'm gonna go to use a bandage and fire a rocket point blank into a wall, and that would be ridiculously annoying. I just kind of had the thought that that gunslinger perk would apply to the Magnum as well. Getting like extra critical hit damage plus 100% damage on a Magnum is a whole lot of bloody damage. So I might try and do that at some point if I can find a group of zombies that's big enough. No, can't go that. Oh, maybe I can. 2, 3, 4. Oh, and then he died. All right, well, never mind. That's actually not bad though. So I guess like judging by the wording of that perk, it makes the last shot do 100% extra damage. So it means that like the fourth shot should, or if you put 4 shots into something, it should always kill him. Like, look at that. Look at that. That's an absolute brutal way to murder some Jeffreys. I killed that guy by doing nothing but shooting him in the kneecaps. I feel a little bad about it, but then at the same time, I really don't. He used to be a zombie, then he took a Magnum to the knee. Yes, here we go. I'll use all the magazines because why not? A Lucky Looter has no use to because I have maxed out Lucky Looter anyway. Neither does a Pack Mule. You guys can just stay there. Although I think Pack Mule increases my strength as well. What the shit was that? What just happened to me? Something broke and I thought a zombie was coming down behind me to rearrange the back of my head. I'll take the water because I don't have any left. I had to drink it all to try and stave off my addiction to fort bites. Be more vultures out here, I'm sure, because I'm outside and it always makes me nervous. It's a nice building, though. I like the aesthetics of the POIs. I say it all the time. Whenever I go somewhere relatively new, I kind of get blown away by just like the quality of the design work. Oh, there's a lot of Jeffreys coming, so it's time for the pistol again. 3, 4. Ah, there we go. Once we get a couple of shots in, then it turns into gunslinger time. We can just ruin everyone's day with a bunch of pistol blows straight to the face. And then, when it's all over, quickly reload and keep on going. It's just that easy. You can fire aimlessly into a crowd. Look at all the zombies who just died. Look at them all. Look at just the carnage. With nothing but a silenced pistol. Sure, it was 44 rounds, but it was 44 great rounds. Head explosion, shoot him in the dick, and he's dead. Who else is around here? Anyone else want a bullet? You want a bullet? Here's some freaking bullets, mate. Bullets for everyone. Oh, I saw you. I saw you coming for me. No deal, you big winged bastard. I saw you flapping your way in, and I was ready for you that time. There's still a bunch of zombies who are awake everywhere that I don't know where they actually are. I really need to find them at some point. You didn't die, did you? There we go, shot you. There's a couple more. They're playing stacking zombies up there, like zombie Jenga. That's okay, I don't mind. If they're all in the same place, I'm happy to murder you. I've also put a couple of points, as you probably ought to tell. There's another one there. Put the last couple of points I just got into boom headshots. That's now, what, increased range weapon headshot damage by 80%, 30% chance to explode heads on hit. So we're looking pretty bloody good. The next one's going to go into run and gun, I think, because I feel like having to reload on the run is going to be a pretty useful skill as I get further and further into this place. Anyone around? Where's the door? No, not that one. Do I just stay up? Let's stay on the catwalk? I guess so. Oh, man, that boom headshot. Who doesn't love a boom headshot? Boom headshot! Going into some close quarters. So I've got, oh, my God! Oh, I got the shotgun out. It was probably a good decision, given what I just climbed down that ladder into. Uh-oh. This is going to be bad. Reload real quick. Oh, my bloody goodness. That was so many zombies to fucking walk into. That was a bad time. I can't shoot much behind. Oh my god, there was one guy right in my grills, causing all sorts of issues. Oh, that was intense. How is there that many zombies in that close quarters? I'm so glad that I had that thought. I was like, this looks pretty close quarters. I even said it, close quarters area, whipping out the shotgun. And the shotgun tore him to fucking pieces. Thank God for that. You ain't laying your bloody blue hands on me. No, thank you. See what I mean? I can hear just so many zombies around there. I don't know where they are. They're over there somewhere. I don't know where. Maybe it was like a wandering horde that showed up and like beating down the walls down the bottom or something. But I can't find them. I don't know where they are. Oh, hey, Arlene. How you doing? Good, I hope. I'm sorry I ruined the Cowboys' favorite part of you, but you just stood up right into it and I couldn't resist. Oh, boy. Oh, that's going to be a whole thing, isn't it? You know what? Let's get the extra bloody damage going for my pistol. But it only sucks, though, because if you miss... Oh, Jesus. If you miss a shot, then you're in some serious strife. There we go. Get them all lined up. There you go, buddy. Kill from a couple of you. Try not to do much. If you miss a shot, it ruins your gunslinger thing. Oh, boy. Oh, that's so many of them. That's so many of them. I didn't bring my bloody rocket launcher out with me. Okay, if I've got a little bit of time, go in here, grab you. Oh, ow, damn it. Okay, stop it. Stop it. Stop with your big bearded bastard. Have a bloody rocket, mate. There you go. Oh, rocket. The rocket is good. These guys didn't die, though. I didn't hit them with the anti-rad, so they're all still, like, getting their health back. Oh, boy. The fight on the helipad was a big one. There's only an hour left until night time. Not that really matters that much. It just removes the possibility that some of the zombies won't be feral. It's like, once it goes night time, I'll get through the freaking door, you ghost. Dude, I hate that. I hate that so much. It's like, what, 10 centimeters short of 2 meters and something you guys are like, what? I can't fit through there, but also I might be able to. I'm just going to sit here and jiggle for a while instead. But yeah, I'm a little bit nervous now because, like, any sort of slower zombies will now be fast and annoying, which just takes away the kind of added benefit to me of having some zombies being slow. Oh my god, I woke up the whole pack. Some zombies being slow, giving you a chance to kind of sort it out, is kind of gone when you've got all the fast zombies ever coming for you. Kill you. Oh my god, okay, I did it dumb. That's okay though. I put one on you. I completely missed. I completely whiffed. Damn it, rocket launcher, you let me down. The good news is though, I'm near the top, which means there shouldn't be much more left of this POI, so I should be almost done. In fact, I think I am done. There's that one there and that one over there. Just drop down here, drop down there. I do want to go to every corner of this place and clear it out. Where did you come from? How did you get all the way up here? I mean, I don't really know, but I appreciate you coming to join me on the roof for this lovely sunset. I'll never get over that. Ragdolling zombies is my favorite thing. Getting some good loot here too. I mean, I've got a level 6 AK. I'll scrap it because I just want the ammo out of it. I don't need to go sell it either. I'm hot. I'm going to prepare some of my weapons as well because I probably should, given how much I'm relying on them. But, like, I went in. I mean, I had more ammo here than I was ever actually going to need. But I've also come out with a whole lot more than I was expecting to. Like, clearing the roof has been a whole thing. Maybe that, like, maybe the helicopter pad was the boss fight of this POI. And to be honest, it wasn't even that bad. The worst part of that was when I dropped down into that, that close quarters bit with the shotgun. And I came up that, like, down that ladder, rather, into about 40 bloody construction zombies. That was easily the closest I was going to get to dying. But it wasn't even that bad, really. I mean, I'm okay with it, though. It means at 2200, as the sun finally sets on a red, dusk, I can go up here. Is this the way up? Is that over here? Where's the ladder? How do I go up? How do I get up to there? Where's, like, the actual way to do it? I could just definitely... Oh, it's over there. I see. You got to make the jump. You got to trust your spidey senses and make the jump across. Still a pretty hefty jump, though. Huh? Ah, nailed it, though. No vultures up here. Doesn't look like it. I think we're all good. Well, there you go. It took me almost an entire day to get through, even being the walking god that I am. It's a nice town here, too. I'm going to miss this world. This has been, like, the best possible seed for the No Crafting Challenge. I mean, I'm sure that I wouldn't have done as well as I did if I didn't have those 3 traders, like, within, what, 100 meters of me? That was, like, the ultimate setup for that. So I'm very glad that I found that one. But, like, yeah, this world has just been very good for me. Big towns with cool POIs and good loot. I'll take the ammo out of you guys, as always. Another repair kit. Don't need that. I'm just looting because I can at this point, just to see what it would have given me. Breakaway into the hardened chest. It's sad now. Now that I've done the POI, I know it's over. And it just makes me a little bit sad on the inside, you know? I've had a great time with this challenge. I'll do it again in Ultra 18, But it's just, I've spent so much time in this world, it's sad to see it go. Well, there you go. The sun has set on another day, but it is also set on this series. I have successfully defeated a tier 5 dungeon without too much of a sweat either. Got punched in the face a couple of times, and like, you know, a couple of little close calls there, plus like I almost blew myself away with a rock launcher a bunch of times trying to get to my bloody bandages. But I would say that is a pretty successful day, a pretty successful series. But I'm gonna have to leave it there. But before I finish this series and this episode for good, there is one more thing that I have to do. It can't be a finale without this. And I feel like it's gonna be like, you know, just a nice little way to close out the series. So that is the end of this POI. Let's go finish it off. So I feel like the best way to end this series and say goodbye properly is to take my wonderful little cabin here that has served me so well, my wonderful house that is on the same street as Three Traders, take this wonderful little cabin and blow it to smithereens. This is full of almost 750 gas barrels. I took all my money that I had earned from all my adventures, took it to the traders and bought every gas barrel I could find. I've turned myself in to an oil baron and filled my bloody cabin and made it my warehouse and filled it with oil barrels from floor to ceiling. Every room in this building has gas barrels in it because, you know, that seems like the right thing to do. This series needed an explosive finale, and if it wasn't me dying in the tier 5 dungeon, it's me exploding my wonderful little cabin. So goodbye black and purple wall, goodbye cash register full of money, goodbye everything I worked towards. It is time to say goodbye to this series, and the best way to do that is by me sitting up here in a little Overwatch position, looking over my wonderful little cabin, holding a rocket launcher ready to kick it all off. So this is the final goodbye to the series. Oh, this is a sad day. It's a bit of a sad day. Let's try not to miss the shot too much. Boom, through the open door. Oh, there it goes. There goes the PC. It's trying to keep up. It's not going to handle it. Even with a fucking RTX 2080 Ti and a top line processor, it still can't handle the explosions of 7 days. Oh, it's sad. It's dragging it out so much longer than it should have. It'd be over by now if you could render it. Oh, my poor little cabin. It's going to be a smoking crater by the end of this. Oh, it's picking up speed. Oh, there we go. And it just kind of went like, poof, like I exploded the balloon full of glitter. Everything. Oh, look at it. Look at it. That's so sad. There's a couple of remnants left over. It's now just a crater of wood piles and destruction. Oh, my poor little house. All the loot is gone. Everything I worked for is gone. This is like my statue. This is the remnants of all that I had in this world. It is now a smoking ruin. Oh, it was a good time. It was a good time for a long time, actually. Quite a few episodes of No Crafting. We've got been here a long time. That seems like a fitting end. So I'm going to have to leave this episode and this series here. A massive thank you to all of you guys for sticking with me for so long. All the support for this series has been wonderful. I will come back and I'll play some more No Crafting in Alpha 18, whenever that comes out. But this episode, this series, and this alpha is now done. So thank you guys for watching. Most of all, thank you to all the patrons of Patreon who made this episode possible. If y'all like, smash the like button down below, subscribe to this channel, follow me on Twitter. If I don't talk to you there first, I'll see you in the next episode. Have a good one.